The legendary Kiriji Memorial College, which was founded in 1952, which produced most of the indigents of Igbajoland and others who are shining stars today, is still the highest educational tower to climb in Igbajoland today. One must salute the sense of communal solidarity and togetherness of Igbajo's sons and daughters, who are recognizable nationally and globally in their own rights, who have been in the vanguard of galvanizing other indigents of Igbajoland, both at home and in the diaspora, to ensure that education in Igbajoland gravitates to the next phase, which is the tertiary level, so that we can also proudly join other cities that can lay justifiable claim to a tertiary institution owned entirely through communal contribution. That is the genesis of the story of Igbajo Polytechnic in the Buluwaduro local government area of Osun State, which sits on a sprawling expanse of land, about 50 hectares of land on the outskirts of Igbajoland. As one approaches the town from the Obokun and Imesile axis, the whole expanse of land was donated by a family in Igbajo. And as of today, virtually all the structures on the permanent site of Igbajo Polytechnic are donated by illustrious sons and daughters of Igbajoland and their friends. Leading in the actualization of the realization of the Igbajo Polytechnic project dream are Otumba Oyewole, Chairman Emeritus of DHL, who is unarguably one of the major financiers of communal efforts by Igbajo sons and daughters to establish a polytechnic owned wholly and purely by them. He and the likes of Chief Inolaji Aboaba, the very first Secretary of Osun State Government, Adegboyega Omolo, SAN, who is the Chairman of the Board of Trustees of Igbajo Polytechnic, and other men and women of substance from Igbajo, capitalized on their connections at high places to secure the registration of the Polytechnic and the accreditation of many courses in the institution. It's to the eternal credit of Chief Olaide Oyewole that today there's the multi-million naira engineering block with 500-seat auditorium and multi-purpose standard football pitch and standard laboratory equipment. The over 90-year-old, proudly highly respected son of Igbajoland, whose daughter, Bola, is married to Mr. Wale Tinubu, a great player in the oil and gas sector, has also influenced her son-in-law to donate to the establishment of the very first community-based polytechnic in Nigeria. As for Chief Solomon Adegboyega Omolo, who has been a senior advocate of Nigeria since 1992, he has committed close to 50 million naira in terms of classroom blocks, block of offices and other amenities. In fact, the e-library in Igbajo Polytechnic has been acquired courtesy of the intervention of Chief Adegboyega Omolo, SAN. Other sons and daughters of Igbajoland who have contributed to the development and growth of the Igbajo Polytechnic in terms of buildings, house on the health center, cafeteria and classrooms are Professor Olaiwola Asungade, who is the chairman, governing council of the school, Mrs. Funke Olowe, Engineer Abiodun Oyedepo, Mrs. Adenike Tugbiele, Chief Olukunle Ojo, an indigene of Igbajoland, former Chief of Staff to Governor Ambode of Lagos State. Club Progresso of Igbajoland has also contributed extensively to the Igbajo Polytechnic project. One illustrious son of Igbajoland who is making all of us proud, whose selfless contribution should be a source of continuous inspiration to the young and old, is architect Oladayo Adegbite. The 60-year-old architect, who is an accomplished entrepreneur and quiet philanthropist, designed all the structures in Igbajo Polytechnic today. He also constructed over 250 executive chairs for the administrative building for members of the governing council and board of trustees of Igbajo Polytechnic. The formal commissioning of the multi-million naira administrative block of the Igbajo Polytechnic, constructed solely by architects Oladayo Adegbite and donated to Igbajo Polytechnic, took place at the institution premises on Boxing Day, 26th December 2020. There were remarks by the donor, architect Oladayo Adegbite, the founder of Isaac Olaiwola Adegbite Foundation, a foundation he named after his father. Chief Adegbite Ademikonra, who is the chairman of the Isaac Olaiwola Adegbite Foundation, and His Royal Majesty Oba Michael Gbadebo Adedeji, CON, or Owaoye of Imesile in Ekiti State, who later commissioned the building.
The Adegbite Foundation actually donated the building, but I'm the one coordinating on behalf of the entire family. We are grateful today because it's one thing to plan a thing, and it's another thing for that project to be successful. We are grateful, especially for my oga that we are honoring today. We actually named the building after my oga, Otumba Samuel Olukunle Ojo. Let us put an edifice here, name it after him, so that generation unborn, when they get to this place, at least people will ask questions, who is this man? How is he to Igbajo? We are grateful for the grace of God upon his life. We are grateful for the assistance that he has rendered to us in Igbajo land. Amalore, amariri won, won ti se gudugudu meje fun wa. Yaya Befa, especially lori polytechnic, anytime I call on him, he is ready, he is willing. Ready, willing to assist. And in fact, any Igbajo sons and daughters that I take to him for one assistant or the other, quickly he will rise up and do it for us. So we are honoring him today. This is just the beginning. We know that several other honors will still come for him.
What we are witnessing here today, to me, is not the beginning. We are very, very close, like he has rightly said. He has done a lot of things for a lot of individuals, for a lot of groups, for a lot of organizations. So, and if he fails to do that in his own land, in his own father's home, then what story will we be telling if Olukunle does not do this? So, in fact, I know, and I know him inside out, that he's going to do more for you. This is the beginning. I envy you. I am indeed very happy for you. Let me tell you, the people of Igbajo, the sons and daughters here, you provided the space for this type of thing. See, people like you are here to witness this. It is because this is very, very important to you. You are interested in the development of your people, in the growth of your people. May God see you through. Amen. It's not an easy job, I know. But if you are determined that you want this job to be easy, it will be easy. In the name of God, in the name of the people of Igbajo, and on behalf of Chipolukunle Ojo, the Dr. Adegbite Foundation, of the rector, thank God for today. So I declare this administrative block open for the use of humanity. In the name of the Father,
Amen.
The Son,
Amen.
And the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
This building was built in honor of Otumba Samuel Olukunle Ojo, Oluomo of Okimesi Ekiti. Owaoye of Okemesi Ekiti. Isaac Olaiwola Adegbite Foundation. Congratulations.
Professor Olaiwola Oshungade, the chairman of the governing council of Igbajo Polytechnic, the rector of Igbajo Polytechnic, Chief Mrs. Christiana Fumio Dejide, also spoke. They all praised the philanthropic spirit of architect Oladayo Adegbite.
I'm highly impressed for this occasion, and I appreciate, even long time I don't see Chief Lutfunde Ojo eye to eye, but long time through my own my in-law, Engineer Akilotimi, always tell me what he's doing in Lagos for our people. And this is an example. I really appreciate him. God will be with him. Mighty name of Jesus Christ.
I want to appreciate sons and daughters of Igbajolan. They are movers. I think I'm going to be a fan. I'm going to be a fan. I'm going to be a fan. They will do it. I've learned a lot from them. If they want to do something that is as high or big as anything, in unity, they do it. Architect Dayo has been wonderful. It's an example to be followed to the core. I'm telling you the truth. It's an example to be followed to the core. And I want to appreciate you, sir, on behalf of every member of the management represented that you have selected to work in this place. On behalf of every student, we are saying a very big thank you.
At the reception later, architect Oladayo Adegbite was given a special award by members of the Osun State Ilerioluwa Next Level Progressive Movement for his exceptional leadership and philanthropic qualities.
Ladies and gentlemen, this decoration you are seeing is bigger than what you are seeing. It is bigger because we have quality people in that group. And so we are giving this medal as a mark of honor to you, as a mark of respect we have for you, as a man that God has given us in the Osun State, as a man that God has blessed with a good wife. I therefore honor you with this medal.
One round of applause, please.
Before we wound down our visits on Boxing Day 2020 to Igbajoland, the home place of Prince Bisi Olatilo, Chairman and CEO Biscon Communications, we took our cameras to main streets of Igbajo to see for ourselves the refurbishing and regrading of the roads, which also takes us to the tarring of the Ada to Igbajo Road, which we hear will gob over 3 billion naira. For this, all sons and daughters of Igbajo land say a big thank you to Governor Adigbo Igao Yetola of Osun State. As for the Igbajo Polytechnic project, which we consider work in progress, all sons and daughters of Isile land must make this an important part of their calculations henceforth.